I want to help you understand the power of manifestation from the perspective of a shaman. It's powerful, it's effective, it works. Okay, we all know that manifesting is the process of putting out an intention, a thought, for an outcome or a relationship or an object or whatever, a scenario that we believe will be beneficial to our lives. That's what smart people do. Now, here's the truth. Everything in your life and everything in my life, whether we like to admit it, whether it's good or bad, is a manifestation. From the shamanic worldview, we know that everything is energy and we are constantly engaging in an energetic field that is responding to our thoughts and intentions. And that's why things show up. That's why we have patterns in our lives of things that continue to show up, because we are continuously feeding the energetic realm with a frequency. And that frequency, whether you are aware of it or not, is powerful, it's active, and it's at work every minute of every day. We know that we have a creator source, a creative spirit that created everything out of an energetic intention. And the fifth principle of shamanism reminds us that the ultimate power is love. So love is the frequency that brought all things into being. Love is the frequency that created everything that is. So whether you're aware of it or not, the things that you're putting out there energetically, the things you're focusing on, I don't have enough money, I might lose my job, I don't feel well, my grandparents died of cancer, that's a focus point. That is an energetic focus point that you're broadcasting to the energetic field, and the energy, whether you are aware of it or not, is responding. And it is meeting your frequency, and it is considering your frequency as an invitation for more of the same to show up. This is what we call the law of resonance, and the idea that like attracts like comes from that law. And in the same way, you might feel that you live abundantly and good things are always coming into your space and everything you need is always there when you want it. And there is no lack in your world and you live abundantly and you walk in that energy and in that power. And so the energetic field through frequency and the law of resonance meets your energetic request. That's how it works. And the shaman knows that everything is alive and vibrating at a frequency. Everything in this world and in this universe as a whole is an energetic frequency taking shape and manifesting. We know from the shamanic worldview, the shamanic perspective, that we live in an ocean of energy that is responding to our thoughts and intentions. We know that there are no coincidences. And we know that everything is coming to us because of the frequency that we've put out there. So in the same way that we throw a rock into a pond or a lake and we see the ripple effect go out, that's how our thoughts are seeded in the energetic realm. They go out as a ripple effect and they look for like frequencies, frequencies that share the same vibrational frequencies. That's the law of resonance. And then those frequencies come back to you because the ripple goes out and then it ripples back in. That is the universal principle. That's how it works. Of the fingerprint of the divine is absolutely everywhere. We see the spiral energetic unfolding in a tree as it grows up out of the earth. We see the spiral in a seashell. We see the spiral in the Milky Way galaxy. We see the spiral in a snail's shell. We see the spiral in a ram's horn or an elephant's trunk. The signature of the creation, the creative spirit, is everywhere around us. And what that is, it is an energetic frequency that is constantly being broadcast. And it is constantly taking shape in physical form and manifesting. This knowledge will see your life change and it will see your manifestations come to fruition. If you sow a seed into the energetic field and abandon that seed, neglect it, and walk away from it, what hope does that energy have to grow and become everything you want it to be? The first principle of shamanism reminds us that the world is as we think it is. And the third principle reminds us that energy flows where attention goes. So bearing that in mind and applying that to the manifestation process, we need to understand that the more nurturing energy we place into our manifestation and the more it occupies our space, the more successful we will be at manifesting and the more chance you give that manifestation to take place. Because in the world of shamanism, you're a co-creator with the divine. You're not a spectator on the sidelines or just a participant. You are a co-creator. Because we've been told throughout many cultures around the world that we were made in the image of God. We were made in the image of the creator, the divine. And so if we're made in that image and we share the characteristics of the great creator, then that's who we are and that's what we can do. Everything in your life and everything in my life is a manifestation based on the energetic seeds we have sown into the energetic field. What you nurture will grow and what you neglect will die. Most people spend their energetic focus on things that aren't in alignment with where they want to be and what they want to see. And that's why things keep showing up in people's lives that they actually don't want. So how do you manifest effectively and efficiently? From the shamanic world viewpoint, we know that the world is as we think it is. We know the second principle tells us that there are no limits. So if you want to listen to the programming and listen to the voices outside of you that tell you that your ideas are stupid and that you can't do that and that's just a childish dream or whatever, where you put your focus and your energy, that will determine what unfolds. The third principle reminds us again that energy flows where attention goes. And every seed, whether it be an energetic seed that we sow into the universe or a seed in the field or in your garden, they need energy. In the physical, the seed needs energy from the water, energy, nutrients from the soil, and nutrients from the sun. In the energetic realm, it needs the energetic focused attention that comes from you, the co-creator. So to continue on with the analogy that we're sowing into a field, we need to cultivate ideas, thoughts, and focus around the things that we want to see showing up. If you're wanting to go into a business and believing you can't do it, you are setting yourself up for failure. If you want to heal yourself from an ism or an itis that's rampant in your body or manifesting in your body, focusing on that problem and focusing on what the world is telling you about that problem is not the pathway to healing. You need to cultivate an attitude and a vibrational frequency that is all about healing. Because as soon as you start investing in, well, these are the symptoms and these are the consequences, and as soon as you start giving energy to those things, what's going to show up? Healing, restoration of yourselves, knowing that you are absolutely able to manifest good health, because the second principle reminds us that there are no limits. And the sixth principle of shamanism reminds us that all power comes from within. So the healing rests with you and you alone and how you approach that healing. To help you manifest your dreams, visions, goals, hopes, come from a place of gratitude. Ground yourself in a place of thankfulness. Have a thankful heart that is constantly thanking the universe for everything that is bringing into your world. Be grateful for the good things in your world and be grateful for the lessons from the things that have shown up that may not have necessarily been where you would have liked them to be. But, you know, take responsibility and thank the universe for bringing the lesson to you so that you can shift your focus. Gratitude is a powerful energy, and the universe responds powerfully to that gratitude energy. Cultivating your dreams, goals, visions, the things that you want to see manifest in your world, comes back to your focused thoughts and intentions. So have clarity around what you want to show up as a reality for you. Be very clear about what it looks like. Know the details of it. Know what you want to show up in your reality, and know what you don't want to show up. When it comes to manifesting the outcomes that we want to see, we need to understand that there comes a point where, yes, we need to nurture the vision. We need to be in alignment with the energies around making that manifestation happen. But we also need to trust in the divine and trust in the outcome. We need to release ourselves from the burden of the outcome, and we need to just be focused on the manifestation and not worry about how it's going to unfold. Because as soon as you start thinking, I need money for this outcome, or I need this, or I need that, then your focused energy shifts to other things, and you, unawares, you sabotage your manifestation because you've taken your focus off whatever it is you want, and you've put your focus on the need to have money. That is not trusting in the divine. That is not trusting. When it comes to communicating our manifestation to the energetic field, to the creator, the creative spirit, we have to remember one thing, and that is that the creative source does not speak English. It doesn't speak French. It doesn't speak Italian. It responds to frequency, because everything is an energetic frequency manifesting and unfolding. So this is why the Navajo talk about thinking in pictures, visualizing the world as you want to see it, visualizing outcomes and not speaking them with words. Understanding that, and understanding that our focused intention and focused attention around outcomes is everything that we need to be focusing on to see manifestations unfold. I sincerely hope that this information has helped you. I hope it champions your cause for great manifestations unfolding within your life. Everything in our lives is a manifestation. We get very distracted and deceived when we start believing that only the things we want showing up are a manifestation. It is not the truth. We create the outer world from within. That is a very, very grounding, foundational understanding of how the world works from the shamanic perspective. Everything comes from within us, because the sixth principle reminds us that all power comes from within. And the seventh principle reminds us that effectiveness is the measure of truth. Look at the language of your soul. Look at the energetic projections that you are broadcasting to the energetic field, and ask yourself, be completely honest with yourself. If you look into the layers and delve into what's showing up, you will know beyond all doubt that everything in your life is a manifestation. And screaming at the outer world and complaining about it is like screaming at the screen at the movies and saying you don't like the movie. You have to go into the projector room and you have to sort things out in here and take responsibility and ownership. Nobody's gonna wave a magic wand over you and say your wish is my command. That is not how it works. This is a personal journey of responsibility and accountability. So when things are showing up, and this is the stuff people don't like to hear, because we live in a world where responsibility is deflected and accountability is shunned. So when you can do that and step into that, you'll see powerful manifestations and you will walk a powerful journey. I hope this has helped. It's real stuff. It works. If you want to know more, visit my website, shanemcleay.com. As we move into these new energies and the new age of understanding, we will see this knowledge, the shamanic original knowledge of energy in the world, start to make a comeback, and people will start to value it once again. So have a great day, and we'll talk really soon.